Hey guys, it's Tyler Folsom here, and today I'm going to teach you how to do the tail whip. So the first thing you definitely need to learn is the foot placement, and it's pretty simple. Just go in your normal riding position. If you're regular, that is your toes pointed right. If you're goofy, that is your toes pointed left. And you pretty much just, I don't know if you guys can see this, but if this is your foot, place it kind of back near the brake and kind of almost like you're wrapping your toes around, and that's really good flicking. And your front foot, put it just right next to your other one. And your feet shouldn't be perfectly vertical, they should be kind of at a slanted angle for best whipping. And just kind of have your foot hanging off a little bit for flick. And your other foot, pretty much just put it in a comfortable position that will be the easiest for you to do the tail whip. When you're learning to flick, first thing you want to do is, first of all, just put your foot in that position that I told you guys earlier, and just practice doing the whip. Pretty simple, just take your foot and flick with your toe. Do it kind of hard to get that practice motion down. And also something called like a step whip, which is where you step, flick, and then jump back on the scooter. It helped me a lot when I was first learning, and it should help you too. When you're first learning the tail whip, you're definitely going to want to have a pretty high jump. Well, I guess it won't be amazingly high, but it's not going to be amazingly low either. You want to have it just the right height to get the full rotation of the flick in, so you can land it smooth and not have to be sketchy. And when you're jumping, don't jump too high, you over rotate, and don't jump so low that you completely under rotate. You just want to get it at that perfect height to flick. When you're jumping, some people do J-hop whips. Well, it's not really, I guess that's what you can call it. It's where your front wheel goes up first, and then your back wheel pops up and you flick. That's one way you can do it. The way is to just jump, just immediately jump with both feet, just doing the bunny hop, and then you immediately flick with your foot, immediately after you're off the ground. And that is pretty much what you need to know about jumping. After you run the tail whip flat, clean, you can start practicing to catch it. And tail whip catching, all you need to do is jump a little bit higher and flick a little bit harder. And like you're gonna wanna try to over rotate it, because then when the deck's under your feet in the air, you're gonna pull up so your feet catch it, so your feet catch the deck. You don't want to push down, because that's just going to make you not, like, do a very, very small catch, and it won't even look like you caught. It'll be like that. So you want to flick, catch with your feet, and then land down. That just makes your tail whips look cleaner, and it helps when you're doing combos, like whip bars, or like other stuff that includes whipping, like whip nose grabs, or whip rise, or I don't know, just pretty much any other trick that includes a whip catch before you do the trick. You're gonna need to know that skill. Now that you've learned all the things you need to know to do the tail whip, you can go out there and try to get them down. Here in a second, I'll show you a quick example of a tail whip, and I hope this really helped you in learning the tail whip, and I'll see you on the next tutorial.